I have a friend named Megan. She's an elementary school teacher. And I was out with her one night, and she was drinking like a monster. And I said to her, don't you have to do a shift at school tomorrow? And she went, I'll just show a video. And I was like, that's why teachers show videos?
I barely got out of high school. I wasn't gonna start that shit all over again. I barely got out, man. My teacher kept me back. I said, what you keeping me back for? I don't wanna see you again, and you don't wanna see me again. Let me go, see what I could do. Maybe all I could be. I used to get on teachers' nerves. They used to hate me. They used to get mad. They say, listen, Chris, if you act up again, I'm gonna call your mama. I said, if you're gonna call my mama, you're gonna have to pay the phone bill because the phone been cut off for 2 weeks. She'd be pissed off. Get out of my room. Make me sick. Go to the principal's office. I'd go to the principal's office. I didn't care. Because I was in the principal's office so much, I was cool with the principal. We were tight. He'd be like, what you do this time? Get in here. Get in here. Get in here. Close the door. Close the door. Close. Sit down. What you do this time? What you do this time? Call my mama, pay the phone bill. Man, you crazy. You crazy. You're a fool, Chris. You're a fool. You're gonna make me suspend your ass. I'm just playing. You're gonna suspend you.
And because I'm from North Carolina, we used to play with tires. Yeah, I'm talking about tires that fell off of a Mack truck, rolled into the elementary school parking lot. Our administrators are like, well, we don't got much of a budget, so we'll figure out something to do with these old things. These were large tires. You stand them up, they're this tall, like 75 pounds, hollow in the middle. We had a hill in the back of our elementary school. So it was our teachers who had to push these tires up that hill. Just so angry, just pushing them up there. They're like, I have a master's in education. We ran up there, we took our little five-year-old bodies and we would... We got into the middle of these tires. Our friend would take their five-year-old buddy, get in the other one. Then it was our teachers who would get behind each tire and get momentum. All right, you little fuckers. Get ready for the ride of your life. And then they push us down a hill. We got speeds of like 20 miles an hour, 40 miles an hour, 60 miles an hour. There's no handle. You're just like, ah! We crashed into a brick wall, flew out of the tire, vomited. Your teacher came down the hill, put her cigarette out on your forehead. She'd be like, recess is dismissed. In fact, school's dismissed. I gotta go meet my man friend who I connected with via the newspaper. And that was recess in the 80s.
I was once in assembly listening to a guy talk about smoking crack. My social studies teacher yelled at me. He goes, sit up straight, show some respect. I was like, he's smoking cocaine. Sit up straight, he's standing on a 45 degree angle. Or as junkies call it, first position. I always got yelled at assembly. That's right, there was always like assembly, and then there was like that second assembly to yell at you for how you behaved at the first assembly. You'd be like, get in here, sit down, sit down, sit down. I wanna talk about what happened yesterday. You're like 8 years old, you're like, what's yesterday? We invite a woman here with homemade puppets to teach you about bullying through skits, and you laugh at this woman? We noticed you had all been bullying each other and making fun of everything constantly, so we invite a woman with straight gray hair in a denim dress with a wrist cast and homemade puppets that all have the same voice to teach you about bullying through skits, and you ha ha ha, laugh it up. What was so funny about that woman? I wanna know. What was so funny about when she couldn't fit the box of puppets back into the trunk of her Dodge Neon? What was so hilarious that you all ran to the windows? Well, you all missed a valuable lesson on the danger of cliques. What's a clique? It's when a group of people hang out together. Oh, you mean like having friends? No. Because these people make fun of other people. Oh, you mean like having friends?
And my music and art teachers were more strict than my maths teacher. My art teacher was a psychopath. So for 2 years, he asked us to draw one tree, just for 2 years. One tree. I couldn't take it. I broke one day and I drew two trees. Imagination. And he saw it and he banged my head into those trees. So the imprint came after this. He taught me a lesson for using my head. So now, whenever I use my imagination, it hurts a little bit.
I took an acting class when I was 10 in New Hampshire. This goes together. And first of all, this acting teacher was mean. I remember he said, like, one assignment was bring in your favorite song and, like, act out to it. And then I brought in my favorite song, which is like, Rest of City Boy, Don't Stop Believing. And like, I thought that acting was mouthing it, so I was like, and he went bananas on me. And you know, I wish at 10 I had the wherewithal to be like, you know what, he's probably going through something. That's his. No, I didn't know to do that when I was 10. I just assumed I was a piece of shit.
I remember going from being the teacher's pet to being the teacher's nemesis in one lesson. And until I was diagnosed, I never understood what had happened. Now, the lesson was on prepositions, so strap yourselves in for this story. Now, I do like my teacher. She's a good teacher. I like the way she explained things, but we lost each other this way. This is how she began the lesson. She said, imagine a box. And I could do that. I was gifted to a point. Visual thinker, good box, solid, three-dimensional, nothing fancy, but there. And then she said, a preposition is a word that explains your relationship to the box. And that's when my thinking just fell apart because I thought, I'm related to a box? And then she said, now, you can be behind the box. Does anybody know what the preposition is there? No, they didn't, but I had a question. I said, am I made of box? Now, let me bring you into my thinking there. I thought if I was related to a box, we must share DNA, and it made more sense in my head that I would be made of box than the box would be made of me. But my teacher was not privy to that gifted train of thought circling my head there. So she was a bit thrown, and she said, no, Hannah, you're not made of box. I'm surprised you had to ask that. I said, okay, you can be in front of the box then. Does anybody know what the preposition is there? No, they didn't, but I had another question. I said, does the box have a name? I thought if I had a name, I could work out how we were related. Maybe we were cousins. And she said, no, it's a box. Boxes don't have names, Hannah. What boxes do you know have names? And I started listing breakfast cereals. She's like, all right, okay. You can be beside the box. Does anybody know what the preposition is there? No, they didn't, but I had another question. Now, I don't remember my thinking behind this question, but I remember asking it because when I did, everybody laughed and I had no idea why. But I remembered really liking the feeling. Uh-oh. This was the question. I said, am I allowed to eat the box? Of course, yes. Everybody is laughing except me and the teacher looking back. I don't know why the fuck she wasn't laughing. As far as jokes go, that's a classic. A baby died, just asked if she was allowed to eat the box. She didn't think it was funny. She's like, okay, all right, okay. Shh, 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 shh. Calm down. Okay, we might be on the wrong track. How about we imagine something else in relation to the box then? Okay, how about a penguin? Now, the penguin can be inside the box. Does anybody know what the preposition is there? No, they didn't, but I had some fucking questions about the penguin. I said, what is the penguin made of? And that was the question that broke my teacher. You know you've broken a teacher when a teacher who never swears, swears bad. So I said, what's the penguin made of? And she's like, penguin? I mean, it's made of fucking penguin.
You kind of sound pandering, but I believe that the pandemic has been hardest on mothers. Definitely hardest on mothers, right? Or the men who had to live with those mothers. It was insane for, I don't know how my wife did it. We had 5 children doing distance learning. And my kids were good. They totally kept a distance from learning. We asked children to do school on the same device they play Minecraft. It's like holding a Weight Watchers meeting in a Wendy's. I mean, it was insane. I definitely gained an appreciation for how difficult it is to be a teacher and what a poor career choice that was.
Everybody remembers this particular type of teacher where she'd see us talking and she'd make a big deal out of it. Ah! 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 We've got a conversation over there, children. Yes, we've got a conversation over there. No, no, no. Stand up. Do you remember that classic line we'd all say? No, but miss, I'm not even doing anything. That's right! You're doing nothing! Now stand up, I said! Do you remember someone in your lesson will try and help you out? Do you remember that one person that will try and help you out and defend it for you as well?
Nah, you know what, miss? He wasn't even talking, you know, I swear to you. I was sitting right next to him, you know, he wasn't even saying nothing. He's actually doing his work this time, you know, miss. I feel like he'd been prejudiced because he's black. I swear to you, he didn't even say nothing.
Does anyone remember the day when your teacher just lost it? Do you remember that day when your teacher just had enough and she just lost her stuff? Remember that teacher just started loading up? What? 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 You can fuck off! Do you remember when teachers lost it? Everyone's talking! New one's listening! And this is teacher's favorite line. Ah, teachers love saying this. For crying out loud, children! Now you. You fuck. Being as you like to talk, you can tell everybody in this class, yes? What osmosis is. No, because like chalk. Yes, you like chalk. So I was in this lesson, so I was like, osmosis. Well, osmosis is actually the process where a high concentration goes into a low concentration. A bit like if you put potatoes in water, they expand with weight and density. Anyway, as I was saying, basically like, this teacher lost her mind, started shaking. How dare you? How dare you? In my lesson, and he'd always say those middle class words you don't understand growing up. How dare you? On the day of the Sabbath. Sabbath? It's Orange Wednesdays. What's this Sabbath thing about? How do I get involved there? Do you know what? You can get out. You can get out. So, you know, walking towards the door, you know, on my way out, you know, I'm spunning the man them, don't know, where I go. But I thought, you know what? I've had enough. I've had enough of being treated like this, you know, feeling oppressed, you know, because right now I'm in year 11, soon I'm going to leave, I'll be in college, making some real money, you know, you know, making some EMA. I said, you know what, miss? I'd actually be listening if you was doing your job, which should be teaching. The whole class simultaneously went, oh, ladies. Listen, I walked out of that lesson, yeah, like I was in slow motion.